Hi, I'm Dr. Laxmi Mehta, a cardiologist at Ohio State Center for Women's Health and Ross Heart Hospital. Heart disease is the number one killer of women, even more so than breast cancer. Approximately 1 in 2 women will develop some form of heart disease in their lifetime, and 1 in 3 will die from it. Previously, heart disease was felt to be a disease of men. But now we know it is not gender sensitive. In fact, more women than men die of heart disease. In the first year after a heart attack, 18% of men and 23% of women will die. It is important to note that there are some delays in the care of women. In terms of diagnosis delay, women arrive to the emergency room 2 hours later than men and often have atypical symptoms. Women often talk themselves out of going to the ER and are great at convincing others why they need to finish the task at hand, such as cooking dinner, before going to the ER. In the past, women were less likely to be offered treatment, including medications, tests, or cardiac catheterization. In fact, women with similar symptoms and risk factors for heart disease as men were more likely to be given an anxiety medication, and the men were more likely to be given aspirin, a cardiac treatment. Knowing the symptoms of a heart attack is vital. Men have more of the classic or Hollywood heart attack symptoms. This includes crushing pain beneath the sternum, radiating down the left shoulder and arm. It occurs at rest and is worsened with activity. Women can have more of the atypical or vague symptoms, including pain in the chest, upper back, jaw, or neck. Also, they can present with only shortness of breath, flu-like symptoms, weakness, anxiety, or loss of appetite. The key is to know your body. Know what is just not right for you and to seek immediate medical attention. If you think you're having a heart attack, should you have your husband drive you to the nearest ER? No, never have anyone but the EMS drive you to the ER. En route, EMS can start treating you with the appropriate medications and can shock your heart should you develop a potentially fatal heart rhythm. In fact, many ambulances are equipped with EKGs, so if a massive heart attack is diagnosed, the EKG can be transmitted to the ER and the patient can be taken straight to the catheterization lab to reduce heart muscle damage and improve the patient's outcome. After a heart attack, many changes are necessary in terms of lifestyle, medications, and cardiac rehabilitation. Women are less often referred to cardiac rehab. And even when they are referred, they're less likely to attend. There are proven therapies that help in the recovery phase and also improve outcomes. So it is often best to discuss with your physician what works and doesn't work for you, as well as alternative options. In the end, we all want good outcomes and a return to normalcy for our patients.